I'm the only person to ever win Survivor 2 times. And it wasn't just luck.
Are you with me or are you against me?
I'm against you, Russell.
That's what I know how to do. Make it to day 39 and not get voted off. The queen stays queen. Adios.
I think it's great that I'm not the only winner here, but I don't think it matters at all. Sandra's not going to be the only 2-time winner, I don't think.
Wow.
Hair tie hanging off the side. Tie goes down.
Wait, those are our chickens.
And the crank goes on top of tie. Wow.
But Sandra, it seems to me if you were going to make the easy vote, it would be you, the 2-time winner.
Everybody loves me, Jeff. What can I tell you? I am the perfect person to go to the end with, because who will give me another $1 million? And these people are playing for the second, the third, the fourth time. How many times do you have to play to get your $1 million? If you're going to do it now and do it with Sandra.
In a sexual way.
First person voted out of Survivor game changes. Sierra.
Sandra is the biggest threat of any returning player because she won twice. You don't win twice by a fluke.
Because I'll tell you what, these non-winners will not award a winner another win.
The only way a winner can win is 3 winners at the end.
That's it.
I want to work with Tony. You know, he's a winner, I'm a winner, like JT's a winner. We do have to protect each other for a little bit. Tony wants me in his alliance of 5. My game is pretty simple. As long as it's not me, I don't care who goes home, which I really don't.
If I'm gonna get to the end, I'm not going with somebody I didn't win.
Exactly. I honestly believe that Tony is gonna help my game. As long as our interests line up, there's no end to the damage we can do together.
I see Sandra and Troyzan walking up my way. I had to bail out of it, and I had to hide.
There's no really threat. Who's going to join forces with Tony?
Yeah, you never know.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Huh? What are you guys doing?
What's going on?
We were just talking about the crate, how the crate is right in front of the fire.
I thought I had aligned myself with Tony, but he's running around acting crazy. He wants to look me in the eyes like the fuzz, like the popo does, like they're taught to do. I don't want to ever deal with that again. There's no telling what this dude would do for $1 million. Tony needs to go home. We're going to turn the tables on him because I don't like what he said. Like, he's the boss.
Yeah.
And he's not the boss. You know that saying where it says, you're only the king until the queen arrives? I'm here.
Sandra put together an alliance of 5 in just 15 minutes. I mean, that's scary. Sandra knows what she's doing. She's won this game twice for a reason.
It was a 2-second conversation. I turn around and there's Tony. Ha, what are y'all talking about? We were talking about the crates and the fire. That was it. But to Tony, everything is paranoia. I don't play like that. I'm calm. That's all. It's just a difference of opinion. Is something in my damn hair?
Probably.
Don't play with me.
Blood everywhere. I ain't play. Ooh, that's huge.
Oh, it's okay. It's all right. Relax.
Jeez Louise.
Going home tonight, but I still have to cast this vote just in case. And as far as Tony's concerned, you're the clown that's going home. And the queen stays queen. Adios.
Second person voted out of Survivor game changers. Tony, that's 5. That's enough. Need to bring me your torch.
Sheep being led to the slaughter. Good job, Sandra.
That's what you get for plotting against me.
Good job.
That's what you get, and the queen stays queen.
You guys are suckers if you allow that to happen.
That's what you get. Take your ass home. Bye, Tony. Say hi to Sierra for me.
Do I have goats?
No,
we didn't find any goats. You have goats?
Goats?
There's goats everywhere here. Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, but don't get too attached because this is going to be our meal.
Yeah.
Sandra don't care about killing these goats. In her mind, it's just food. She was a villain for a reason.
I was so tired to go, but now it's a mommy goat.
Mm-hmm. I know, it's so sad, isn't it?
I don't see anything wrong with killing and eating a goat. That's what they're here for human consumption.
Sandra, you're not surprised by this. You are clearly a threat in that you've never lost.
Oh, I'm not worried. I know I'm not going home tonight. How about that?
I think this is a stupid time in the game to be thinking about anything except physical threats. That's where I am. You asked me where I sit among this group, and I was honest.
Culpepper, football analogy, an audible, perhaps a change of plan?
Potentially, although they came in lock, stock, barrel in their original plan.
If that's how we're gonna be.
Wow.
It's on you.
How are you doing?
I'm scared.
I just better wet myself.
What the hell are you going on here, Jeff?
There's like less chance than Tony.
Oh my gosh.
She wants Brad Culpepper to go because he doesn't have an eye. Don't say he's a physical threat.
Unprecedented. If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Do it. Do it. Do it. Yes.
Jeff?
Yes. I found something this afternoon. Little necklace. I think I'm going to give it to... Who wants it? Pretty lady. Here you are.
Fourth person voted out of Survivor Game Changers. Malcolm. That's three. That's enough. You need to bring me your torch.
I'm gonna vomit.
How is it that Ty gives Sierra the idol of all those people there?
I don't know.
Somehow that name slipped because how would Ty, of all people, give it to her?
Culpepper.
And Ty turned around and Culpepper said Sierra. And Sierra went like this to him and took it and put it on her.
I told him it was safe. Yep.
I'm pissed. JT's hands are all over this. This is JT's dirty deed. And if he knows how I am, I'm gonna turn around and send his ass packing right behind Malcolm if I can. He crossed me, it's payback time.
Whoa! I like it.
So JT was annoyed that Michaela was using 1 tablespoon of sugar for a tiny sip of coffee. So I had a sweet idea, and I said, I'm just gonna go ahead and eat the rest of the sugar. And that's what's left of the sugar. We'll finish the sugar off. That'll add fuel to the fire because he'll think it was Michaela. The only other person here that uses the sugar is JT and Michaela. So I knew JT would blame Michaela for the sugar jar being empty.
Damn, sugar's gone.
I know who's been eating it. Who's been eating the spoonfuls at a time? Michaela.
Way on the inside, so that means she licked it. I swear.
Let me see this jar of sugar she licked. I mean, and that's it for this jar.
That's it, Anna.
This is done.
I told you, that's crazy.
Because JT uses sugar for his coffee, and there was no sugar left, so he thinks Michaela actually licked the container where the sugar was. This is for real.
That's how stupid he is. What am I gonna put my tongue in a sugar jar for?
The queen stays queen. Adios.
If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so. Okay, once the votes are read, the decision is final. Person voted out will be asked to leave the tribal council area immediately. I'll read the votes. Fifth person voted out of Survivor Game Changers. JT.
Damn.
Need to bring me your torch?
Tell Malcolm you sent him home, too.
I will.
Damn, you guys are good.
And I didn't steal the sugar either. I don't know where it went.
You took the sugar?
Everybody drop your buffs.
What a crazy game.
Oh, my God, Jeff.
Which one's the good one?
I don't know, but I'm going to get stuck with everything nobody else wanted. The new Nuku tribe, Sandra, Sarah, Varner, Andrea, Ty, Zeke, and Ozzy. Sandra and Varner now in the minority spot. Sandra, you're in the back row, hands are in your pocket, you're not saying much. What are you thinking, Sandra?
I'm optimistic. I hope they get to meet me first before they decide if something goes left that I end up right. Of all three times I've played Survivor, I think this is the first time I feel like something could go wrong. Varner's telling me that Ty's going home, but I don't believe it. So I can't just hope for the best. I need to assess the situation and work my magic. You're smart. You know this game.
Yeah.
You know this game. And if the merge is coming, the last thing you guys need is Debbie, Ty, and Aubrey together. I laid out the scenario of the Karong three. Aubrey's still here, Debbie's still here, and Ty's still here. They could say that they're not best of friends, but at the end of the day, these people share something no one else shares. They played that one season together. And when you come out to play a game like this, you usually stick with what you know.
I don't like that.
Yeah.
You're a very strong female. Sarah's a very strong female. You're a very strong male. And if you need someone to help you, protect you, I'll keep my eyes and my ears open. I'll let you know what's going on, what the scoop is, who's coming after you, who's saying what about you. I can help you guys.
Yeah.
Everybody loves you right now.
Yeah.
But when it goes left and it's every man for himself, you guys are the ones that are gonna go out the door.
Sure.
It always happens. You've been there, done that. It's been 16 great days, Jeff, but I think this is it for me.
Sixth person voted out. Sandra, that's four, that's enough. Need to bring me your torch.
I wish you guys luck. It's okay, you guys knock it out.
Sandra, for the first time in 94 days of Survivor, the tribe has spoken.
Don't do it, Jeff. Don't do it. Don't do it, Jeff. Good luck.
The queen.
Time for you to go.
All right.
Bye.
Bye, Sandra. Bye, Sandra.
I did good for 16 days, considering I'm a two-time winner. I owe a lot to Survivor, and I love Survivor, and it's in my heart. I don't want to get teary, but I know why I live the life that I live, and it's because of Survivor. There will never be another two-time winner except the queen.